This talk is little odd, but for two reasons actually. First is the domain, which is machine design, not machine learning, at least initially. Then we'll come to machine learning and deep learning later. And second is, I'm being a teacher also. Rather than you asking me questions, I'll be asking you questions. Is that okay? Maybe later you can ask me questions, but initially I'll ask you questions. Any mechanical engineer in the audience? Oh boy, I thought there would be none. Still, I'll give you some background. So the domain is machine design and use of neural network in some help to that. So what is machine design? Say designing products. I'll explain that. I'll take the questions last. So if you're designing a chair like the one that you're sitting, basically, what are you doing? You are deciding the shape. This is the shape. You are deciding the material. So it is whatever, aluminum, iron, whatever. And then deciding the dimensions, how thick the base would be. This thick, or this thick. Traditionally, how do you decide the minimum thickness that sustains your weight? 80 kg, 90 kg, 100 kg. How do you do that? You basically make 10 chairs. Different thickness, have people sit on it, whichever the minimum one breaks, that's the design, right? Traditionally. But of course, once the computers came, you don't do that, at least initially. You design those shapes on computer. And this is what is called as CAD, computer aided design. You design those shapes on computer, and then you analyze also them on computer. Strength analysis, putting some load, will it sustain or not? So, you can make 10 chairs, but you cannot make 10 aeroplanes, right? So you have to design and do strength analysis on computer. This is a special case in this analysis. If the shape is a little thin, like sheet metal shape, have you heard of sheet metal? Something like this. Sheet metal, where the thickness is constant, but the other dimensions are far more than the thickness. So this is what is thin wall or sheet metal shape. Like car bodies or aeroplane bodies are sheet metal. There is a trick. As the thickness is constant, we assume that the stresses or the deflections are same. So at least one dimension goes off for us to worry for the strength analysis. That's the idea. These things may look little alien, but I'll come to the shape problems slowly and quickly actually. So, what is CAD? Designing shapes on computer. CAE, doing strength analysis. You cannot take shape just like that and put it to CAE. If the shape is thin, what you do, you create a surface within the thickness. And what is the advantage? Instead of doing very complicated 3D analysis, it changes to a surface analysis. So from solid, you can convert to surface, and then the computations are reduced a lot, but the results are equivalent of deflection and all. So if you had a product like this, what you do, can you see there is some thickness, it's a sheet metal like or plastic shape. You make a surface first and analyze that. So if you put some load here, it is equivalent of putting load here and doing same analysis. But as you can see, this being a surface, number of nodes, points to calculate deflections or stress are far less. So this is what is called as mid-surface, the surface that is in the middle of the thickness. I will come to the domains quickly, don't worry. So the idea is, given this shape, can you calculate this shape by some means? It helps, because if you are doing solid analysis, the results, and if you are doing a surface analysis, results are almost similar, but the timing is reduced because the calculations are less. That's the idea. So this has been in use for 30, 40 years. If it is a thin wall component, you have to create a surface in the middle. That much everybody is okay. We need to create a surface in the middle. Let's take simpler example, just for us to assimilate. If this is the solid shape, this is the surface shape. The only condition is it has to be morphologically, it should look similar, right? If you have shape like this, it cannot be L, right? It should look similar so that the analysis will be similar. Are we okay with this so far? Given the shape, can you calculate this surface, what is called as mid-surface? So this is a function, this is a transformation from solid to surface, this is a dimension reduction, okay? One dimension is less. Is it easy to calculate this mid-surface? Just look at the solid. What is this solid made up of? This face, this face, this face. You have a list of faces coming to us as an algorithm. Can you compute this? So this is the dimension reduction research or the algorithm that we want to develop. Getting mid-surface is not easy. It's not a trivial problem. It is going on for 50, 60 years. Still the problem is not solved because of the complication. I'll show you the latest results. Are we all okay so far? Many CAD CAE packages, those who are mechanical engineers may know, AutoCAD, parametric, geometric, others. They do that and we will see how they do that or what is the result. Can you see some issues? This is the input shape that has gone in and this is the calculated mid-surface, almost latest result. Given surfaces of this shape like this, it is not possible to calculate mid-surface. So this is the original problem. The one that I'm going to talk about is far diluted one, for the easier understanding, okay? This is the original problem. So forget the mechanical engineering part, now we are in the shapes domain. Given this shape, can you calculate a good mid-surface? Is that okay? Because we cannot tolerate gaps. If your chair had a gap, what the analysis would be, right? It will just break there and there itself. So we cannot tolerate gaps. Let's take this simple example. Letters. Model as a solid, what its mid-surface would look like, we can at least intuitively understand, it should look like Yogesh only, right? The current output that we get is this. Can you see issues? This is one of the latest output from a highly commercial, highly expensive package today. So there are issues. And I'll just zoom into one of the things. If you have an output shape like this, the mid-surface that automatically comes is like this. It doesn't get connected properly. So this transformation from solid to surface, this function, we always call it as a function, right? Input to output, is still to be learned well, or at least heuristically or even algorithmically, okay? So this is the current quality. What people do? Do they abandon this method? No. Mid-surface is so computationally nice or less compute intensive that they still do it. Let there be gaps, then people are put on the job to patch up the whole thing, and the patch up goes for 2 weeks, 3 weeks. Still the whole aeroplane or the car body is mid-surfaced first, patched up really nice, and then the analysis is done. So mid-surfaces are important. The computation is far faster because actually it's just not one computation. You can do iterative computation, change the thickness, again run, change the thickness. Once we have mid-surface, we are done. Then we can do experimentation on thicknesses. So even if the quality is bad, even if the manual patchwork is needed, we still do it and correct it manually. So this is the problem, original problem. Let's look at a very simple shape, okay? A shape like this, a plate. How a shape is designed in a CAD package? You take a profile, rectangle, you extrude it or sweep it so that the solid is formed. Is that okay? I'll repeat. How a plate is formed? You take a rectangle and sweep it. So this plate is formed. What would be the mid-surface? Instead of the rectangle getting swept, you can put a middle line and sweep it. Are you all getting? Last row. So instead of rectangle being swept, a line, if it is swept, it's a mid surface of the same solid. Now the problem is reduced to it. So initially we wanted to do mid surface of a complicated shape. Now we are coming to the plate. For a rectangle, can you calculate the middle line? Now my second question. The first one was any mechanical engineers here. The second question is, given four lines, a long one, short one, long one, and again short one, can you calculate the middle long one? I'll give you 30 seconds. By the way, this research is going on for 30 years. You have 30 seconds. Can you think in mind what would be your algorithm? Just think. I'm not going to ask you. And whoever cracks it, just raise the hand. Don't spell it out. Okay? What is the input? Four lines. 1, 2, 3, 4. And the output is middle line. Think. Whoever has cracked it, I'll give you my solution, which is dumb solution, and then we'll develop on that. Okay? Who has got it so far? The problem is at least input-output wise very clear, right? Forget the computation. My solution would be, find the biggest one, find the shortest one, because we just get four lines, right? Nothing else. Find the biggest one, find the shortest one, shortest half, the biggest one offsetted or translated. You are so same? Same? Wonderful. One of the, I should not say dumbest solution that is possible. Now you have this solution in mind. Apply it to T now. Apply to T. How T looks? This, 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 this. Are you able to imagine how T looks like? Get the biggest one. Get the smallest one, half. Is it a T? No. Problem? No. So we are developing an algorithm for any profile, thin profile. Can you calculate a mid curve now? We had initial algorithm, longest one, offsetted by the thickness half. Is not working. Can you develop this little further? Now we can split. So there are various ways people have tried, and I'll show. This is the first paper came, I think, in 1967 of doing this, and the algorithm is called as grass fire algorithm. If you have any shape, assume that it's grass, it's a lawn, and you have started a fire from outside. As the fire comes in, wherever it meets, that's the midcurve. Okay, this is one of the conceptual understanding. I'll show you a few more examples. So, for us the problem is, given a shape like this, black, can you calculate the red shape? Say for Y, say for L, for any shape like this, thin shape. Is problem clear? Forget mechanical engineering now, even solid to surface. Now we are in 2D, complete 2D, and we are going to solve this problem. Given outer profile, can you calculate the middle one? Is it okay? Think about it. There have been quite a few approaches. I've put them very simplistically here. But this is, of course, 50, 60 years of work of people, other people. What they do, I'll just quickly explain. This is called as medial axis transform. They assume that the ball is rolling, whichever is touching the profile. And you take the loci, or the collection of the centers. That's the midcurve. Now we'll see, it's not exact midcurve like the middle line. It has some branches. But still, this is commercially used. People will remove the branches and still use it, because this method works. Another method that you may not have thought, mesh it. Get all the midpoints connected. And this will work for any shape, not just the rectangle that we saw, or T, or any shape. Third one is thinning, that I just mentioned, offset from every side, whatever is left, that's the thing. And the last one is pairs. You find opposing pairs and get the midcurve. There are far many approaches, I've just listed few. Is speed okay? Mechanical engineering? Okay, I'll come back to the original problem. If the part is thin, we get mid-surface because the computation is less, but we get equivalent results. That's the original problem. So solid to surface was for that. Number of nodes to calculate stresses are less. Instead of doing 3D, too many degrees of freedom, if you have surface, far less number of freedom. And we have reduced that problem to now profile only, 2D profile. 1967 till now, everybody is adding something to this, how to do dimension reduction of a shape with as much less error as possible, and it should be applicable to any shape per se. This is my PhD work. Subtopic, actually my PhD is on mid-surface, and one of the subtopic is of course profiles. Given a shape like this, my implementation would calculate like this. So you can say, at least for simple shapes, it is more or less okay. But things are not all rosy. It was fully rule-based. Had algorithms running into pages. And the one that I used was called cellular decomposition. You cut the shapes, make standard shapes, have standard midcurves, and connect them together somehow. Okay, that's the idea. If any new shape comes, we are stuck. New logic, not scalable. T was two rectangles, L was again two rectangles with a slanted line. I think it's fairly easy to understand. Fully rule-based. Now this transformation from 2D profile to a 1D curve, can neural networks learn that? So that's the topic today. So people have been trying for 50, 60 years, can we put a dent in this research? Can we do it completely different way? Forget rules. That's what machine learning is all about, right? Forget the hand-coded rules, heuristic rules. We'll just provide what? Inputs and outputs, and let somebody figure out, meaning neural network figure out, right? The weights. That's the idea we've been toying. How? Supply lots of examples. We know actually, intuitively we know, given a shape, how its midcurves should look like. Supply them as much as possible. Can it learn the dimension reduction? Okay. But things are not that easy also. So what is the idea? Supply lots of training data, input, output, let it learn. What is the use? Given any unseen profile, it will calculate the inferencing. This is training, this is inferencing, right? That's the idea. What would be the input to the problem? Anybody? I'm coming back to the basics. What is the input to this problem? Dimension reduction, 2D profile to 1D curves. What is the input? What are the inputs? For a profile, what is, how profile is defined? Points, set of points. So for a polygon, 1, 2, 3, 4. Assume that they are connected, so they are lines. What is the output? One line. So 4 lines to 1 line, first pair. What would be for L? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 lines and 2 lines. Are we all okay with this? Input and output. Supply as many profiles that you know. Let it learn. So supply set of points or connected lines, non-intersecting. So these are some caveats, some mathematical things. Assume that it is a closed polygon. You are aware of these terms, right? And the output is polyline. Okay? Simplistically. So it's a dimension reduction problem, like PCA. PCA people have done. PCA is used here as well, but little differently. So given a shape like this, black shape, can you calculate red shape? Only condition, it should represent the original shape. Y should be Y. Y should not be L. The whole purpose will be lost. Is it like a translation? Can you see what is the input? Number of lines on the left hand side, like English. Number of lines on the output side, like French. We have seen a lot of machine translation talks in this workshop. input some sequence, output. So is it a sequence to sequence problem? In a sense, yes, at least initially. I'll give you counter examples. So is it a sequence to sequence problem? Can we tackle it machine learning way? Anybody? LSTMs, bidirectional LSTMs with attention, all those things. It's not really a sequence to sequence problem. I'll give you some counter examples. Consider O. What is O? Two concentric circles. What is the output? One circle. Is it a sequence on the input side? You started with having 4 or 5 points representing an outer circle. How do you jump to the inner one? If you have the next point as the inner one, the line gets connected. So it's not really possible to represent even input shapes. Are you getting the difficulty, challenge? If you have loops, you just cannot represent the data itself. Got the challenge? Output challenge is why? What is why? Is it a polyline sequence? 1, 2, should I go here as the next point or should I go here? So there are branches. So input is not a sequence, output is also not a sequence. Ideally, it is a graph to graph translation. Graph, disconnected graphs to disconnected graphs. This is very difficult problem to solve. To my knowledge, I did not find any solution on GitHub. So I said it's not solvable, right? That's what my limited understanding of deep learning. If it is not there on GitHub, it's not done. Is it an autoencoder problem? What is autoencoder? Input and output same. Here is not case, input and output are different, but it is an encoder-decoder problem, right? We'll see. Some graph structure here, network, graph meaning network. Some network here, we want to do transformation, translation. So there are variable size encoders, decoders. So what do they do? If you have in machine translation, you have 5 words English, say 7 words French. What do? Anybody? You're machine learning people, right? You do padding. You add extra minus ones just to make the lengths similar. Can you do padding here in case of geometric points? So you decide minus one is to be padded with. That minus one becomes a valid input because this minus one is a valid point, right? So you cannot pad with anything. Again, a different problem. So too many problems. Input cannot be represented, output cannot be represented, padding cannot be done, sequence to sequence, graph to the graph, networks not available, variable size issue is there. What to do? Any solution? Any spark? Can we use images? Forget geometry now. Forget mechanical engineering. Forget solid to surface transformation. Now we have boiled down to profile to curve. Both things are not representable. So an easy way out for which GitHub solutions are available is image to image translation. Are you getting it? What has been solved by image to image? Fixed size, 28 by 28, 100 by 100 input, even 100 by 100 output. Inside figure can be anything. Some pixels are black, rest everything is white, grayscale. So we have converted the original geometry problem to image translation problem. 2D image. Images are 2D, to my knowledge. The 3D things are called voxels. So if we supply, forget the geometry problem now, forget mechanical engineering, given this shape and this shape as an image, 28 by 28, 100 by 100, whatever you decide. Can we learn the transformation? Now this is in a solvable domain, right? We are in our land now. That we are familiar. Forget, no sequence to sequence, nothing. So what are inputs? Given an input like this, image, output image like this, input image like this, output image. Is this a midcurve? If you supply hundreds, thousands of such images, input and output, can neural networks learn at least this, image to image? So what would be the idea? Once you give unseen shape, whatever, thin shape, can it give me midcurve in image? Forget from image to geometry, that part we have forgotten. Are we all okay? Now I'll just mention few solutions that we have tried. The biggest problem is, so input, what are the inputs? Shapes like this, and outputs are also known, but in the image format. It solves, as I mentioned, all those problems. We'll try encoder-decoder network. Given a shape like this, it will have some network here, simplistically few nodes, maybe CNN, convolutional nodes, layers, something else which is far fancier. It gives you to some compressed state or hidden state, and then you expand back. How does it learn? This pair, whole thing goes forward propagation, some error, back propagation, over some epochs, weights are adjusted, weights are stabilized. Right? Once the model is ready, meaning weights, values are ready, any new shape, same weights, that's it. Simple. Problem has been reduced dramatically to a very achievable state. In neural network, we need lots of data. This work was actually only personal in some sense. So how many profiles can I make? 10, 20, 25, not like million, right? So if I have 5 profiles, just like this, how can I populate at least hundreds or thousands? Any ideas? I want very simple. I'm a mechanical engineer. So GAN is, so left. Okay. I'll probably talk to you later how to generate. I would need such solution. But just simply, given few profiles, input profiles and output, how can you have variations? Correct. Not actually, it's a 2D profile and a 1D profile. Curve. It's a profile and a curve. As he rightly said, can we transform both of them similarly? And I can have many variations as much as possible. So both are there. 5 degrees, 10 degrees, 20 degrees. So can I populate at least 36 types for each? 10 degree rotation, 5 degree rotation, more, 2 degree rotation, translation, both translated. So geometrically points would be different, but shape wise both are same. So this way I populated. So original data is like this. A picture comes like this. This has been taken as an image now. So the original problem, image, original output, image. What can you do for data augmentation, making many variations? Original data was in vector format. If you are aware of image technologies, vector is actually a curve equation. Then you do rasterization. You put pixels from the image. And then you can do translation, reflection. These are actually different operations, mirroring, rotation, and scaling. All these operations can be leveraged to populate different variations of same L, thin L and the profile L, right? You do variations and then you can generate lots of data, which is supervised, actually correct. A simple Python program with given transformation matrix, those who have done 12th probably know transformation matrices. You can generate lots of samples. Now these can be fed to neural network. Is that clear so far? Mechanical engineering, solid to surface. Forget the solid part, profile to 1D. Geometry is not suitable, gone to images. In images, to create variations, we have transformations. Now, is this a routine work. Like scikit-learn, you have 3 lines of actual modeling code. Rest is all data pre-processing. This is all what we have done so far. Data is ready. Many options are available. Simple encoder-decoder network. If you have less data, simpler would be better. If you have more data, then you can add layers. So what is simple encoder-decoder? Whatever input size, if it is 100 by 100, what would be the input size? 100 into 100, 10,000. Output is again 10,000, but with different pixels colored, isn't it? So simple one layer encoder-decoder network, that's what I'm showing today, some results. But you still can have dense encoder-decoder, multiple layers in the input, multiple layers in the output. You can have CNN nodes, layers. And then there is something called as PICS-to-PICS, probably which is more popular in this domain. PICS-to-PICS, I have some theoretical issues with that. But these are basically input-to-output image translation networks. This is what, these are what we can leverage. So I've used this. This has been, of course, this has been stolen picture. This is called as image segmentation. Original photo and a segment, the portions photo. If you feed such pairs, it learns the segmentation. Why it is used? If you want to block, say, trees only or the background, this can be taken into different color and then you can superimpose. So it's used for blanking generally. So very popular in the image domain. So this is what I've used. I did not want to show code, but still, if you don't show code, going to conference. So simple Keras network, one layer, and these are the results. I'll wait here for a moment. There's input on the top, and these are inference results, not training results, inference. Given a shape, it gives me shape like this. Given a shape, it gives shape. Obviously, they are not crisp and clear. There is noise, there are a few dots here and there, which are misclassified pixels. But the good part is that simple one layer encoder decoder, you can at least positionally correct. If this was the line, if the line did not come here, at least the spatial position, it understood well. The learning has happened, right? Simple encoder decoder, you can see the learning has happened. This source code is available free on GitHub. If you type just MidcurveNN and Yogesh Kulkarni, you will get the GitHub thing. I did try a couple of others. The other solutions could be, you have this output and have a denoiser on top of it, which removes the noise, and that could be better in PICS to PICS. So this is what I got, probably last few slides. Not very perfect, but encouraging. To my knowledge, this is the only work that I have seen. As I have done doctoral work, I have done enough literature survey that anybody else is doing it or not. It's because that is the point of the work. To my knowledge, nobody has done it. So this is at least start with a simple encoder-decoder. People can come up with, those who are familiar with this or more expert, can come up with different architectures. Data is available free. You can populate more data. Start doing that work and contribute to that GitHub. If you have fantastic results, we can co-author the paper. Co-author meaning your name will also come. So that's it. So okay results, but this is just the start. So that's what I wanted to talk in this conference, a new domain altogether. Machine design to so-called machine learning is what we have done. Of course, deep learning. And what can be done? More profiles, more data, and different architectures. I'll take the questions now. Many, I mean, we can tweak the error functions and all also. That's it. Just some summary. Not just for machine design. I thought I should apply a few more examples. It is used in animation also. If you have a 2D profile of a man, a skeleton is actually given movements. And the further, the muscle part is actually rendered on the So you don't have to transform everything in the animation. Only the skeleton has to be transformed. So this is skeletonization also. Given the skeleton, you can add mass. You can do that. This is a reverse medial axis transform. You can do shape matching. If you want to retrieve shapes, instead of going for matching every surface, you match the skeleton. Right? So it's easier to get. Are you getting that? So there are many applications, but the one that I showed was strength analysis. Many approaches going on for 50, 60 years. And this is the beginning, doing the same transformation by deep learning. That's it. Am I okay on the time? Okay. I think perfect. It's at 4:35. Just one note. I do have a paper on it, a brief paper on it, on Vixra, the opposite of archive. It's public paper. If you want to study a little more, you can just take a look at the, some theory part is mentioned there. Anyway, yeah, please. Okay. Accuracy is actually very simple here. If you have a L-shaped pixels, you have to have L here at that location only. It cannot even deviate. So the error function, if the pixel was there or not, simple. Very strict error function. In case of GANs or whatever pix-to-pix, it actually, the second network is actually a cost function adjuster. So it allows what is good output. I don't want good output, I want perfect output. So a simple error function is actually better than going for a little sophisticated but good sort of output. So and something else is completely inaccurate. So it has to be there at that position and those pixels only. Because by definition, if you deviate a bit, that's not L anymore. And it's not in the middle. So it's a little strict in that sense. Yeah.
So this is definitely encouraging because you have come up with something in mix of, say, mechanical term and neural networks. But do you think that this sort of approach would any day yield better results than what you conventionally do? Do a measurement and then come to the mid-surface?
One cannot predict. It's a new technology. At this moment, no. The rule-based ones, though they figure very miserably, as you saw some examples, they still work better. Even my doctoral work was far better than this. I could solve many shapes, even the non-letter shape also, horse and other animals also. So that's a 60-year-old work. A 3-month, 4-month work won't compete with that still. But some progress will come. The potential is you don't have to worry about rules anymore. Just good examples or good too many examples and a decent matching network. That's the way it will take it further. Don't know whether it will be good or bad, but that's the start. Yeah. Yes. It doesn't matter now. Can you see? It's an image. You can have 3, 4 O's, whatever. It doesn't matter. It's an image to image. All that sequence problem is completely gone. Only problem is if you get output like this, I do not want image, I want surface. So somehow I have to vectorize it back and extrude it, removing the noise. And as I said, removing all the errors. It has to be a perfect connected dots, then I'll be able to extrude it well. So the post-processing is heavy as of now because the output is not good.
Stitch.
So,
will you feed that manually stitch data as a training data or you will stick to the...
That domain is completely different because that algorithm itself is different. So, they have not catered to some cases.
But they are also generating some training data for you?
No. They are rule based.
Okay.
This is what I also did in my work. So, given 10 surfaces, what do you do? Take the top 2 surfaces, make a pair, another top 2 surface, make a pair. Put an offset patch and extend and trim. This is the normal approach. This is called as mid-surface by pairs. I've worked as an internal software developer for that algorithm as well. 20 years back also, and then recently also for a different company. That's the approach. Completely rule-based. No training data as such. I did not, it's a short brief of my work, but once an extended proper journal paper will come, I will have to put benchmarking. I will have to push the current state of the art. No, this was highly rule-based, heuristic rules. Heuristic rules. Yeah.
Okay. Gaps, and you know you could probably do an ensemble in a way.
Wonderful. For all this you need data. You need to have a gapped surface and a filled surface. If you have millions of such data, give me a call. Because somebody has to prepare the pairs, right?
But it's already being done by the industry, right?
Correct.
They begin with this and then they
Wonderful. As you rightly said, for a shape, a gapped shape and a filled shape. If you have many such examples, then we can get that training data somehow and start learning similar way. So that's possible. The problem there is it's a 3D shape. We have to sample all the points. So 3D is a very difficult problem. That's why I showed you a 2D thing first. If 2D works fine, then we'll go to 3D. Thank you all. Thank you for coming. Any other question, catch me offline. Thank you.